Went to link. Actually, I saw two videos only. I have got some idea about the Scrum. The Scrum team have consist of like team members are like Scrum Master, then developer development team is there, then product owner will be there. Then they will have meetings, you know. It's like meeting, like sprint planning meeting will be there. Then daily Scrum meeting will be there. Then sprint retrospective, then meeting will be there. So then finally, I guess sprint review meeting is also there. So this type of meetings are there.
There are five ceremonies here. Product backlog grooming, sprint planning meeting, your sprint, daily stand-up meeting, then we have the sprint review meeting, and then sprint retrospective meeting. So technically they are called ceremonies, but it's just a fancy word for meeting. Now, the Scrum framework, as I said, got five ceremonies or five meetings: product backlog grooming, sprint planning meeting, daily stand-up, sprint review meeting, and sprint retrospective. Now, if you look at the literature of Scrum, there are only three roles they have defined. That is a product owner, the team, and the Scrum Master. Product owner is similar to, like a customer who has requested you to do something or to build a solution. Product owner is coming from the business side. Now, there can be a scenario where your customer is different than the product owner, but the product owner is a person who is in charge of giving the whole team direction in terms of how that solution has to be built. What has to be built, not how, sorry, what has to be built. So he or she is giving you the requirements, right? So the product owner is coming from the business side, and he or she is the voice of customer. That means, you see, you may have a scenario where your application is going to be used. Let's suppose you are a product owner, and you are in charge of giving all the requirements to the team. But you may not be the end user. You may be, you may not be, right? Or you may be one of the end users, and there might be other end users as well. So you may have to talk to other stakeholders, but you will be that one point of contact who will be responsible for all the requirements which will be presented to the team.
So what we have to deliver, I mean, what is a customer's exact requirement is what a product owner knows, right?
That's correct. So he or she may have to talk to other stakeholders to understand what needs to be done, what features are requested, right? The priority in which we need to implement them. All of that will be done by the product owner. And he or she will be the person who will be putting all those requirements into the product backlog. As you can see here, that's a product backlog. Product backlog is, think about it as a virtual container which has all the requirements that needs to be implemented to build a solution.
So product owner only give the product backlog.
Product owner will maintain the product backlog. Now, that doesn't mean that no one else can add, edit, or make any changes to the product backlog. Anybody who is part of the team has access to the product backlog. They can add any, what we call the product backlog item, PBI. So we keep talking about the stories, right, in the meetings. So majority of part will be the stories, a user story that will be in the backlog. But we, let's call it a PBI, product backlog item, because there are many more things apart from stories. There can be a defect. There can be any technical work that needs to be done by a developer, or an analysis task that has to be done by a solution architect or a developer or a BA, whatever, right? But that work has to be done towards the completion of the project. So anything that is required or any task that has to be completed, right, towards the project should be in the product backlog. So PBI is a generic term. PBI can be a story, can be a defect, can be a technical task, can be an epic, anything of that sort. So let's call it a PBI right now.
Okay.
Okay. Now, who is working with a product owner? It's a business analyst who is working most of the time. Now, here at this point of time, let me give you a disclaimer, right? As per the theory, the product owner has to work with the whole team when the grooming happens.
Exactly.
Okay? So grooming is nothing but adding more information to the stories and making it more meaningful, making it more complete so that the team understands what needs to be done. So PO can work with the whole team in the grooming session, and it's more about, let's say, the PO will take one story at a time, and they will discuss that story with the developers, with the testers, and they will update it based on the feedback they get from the team. Okay, but it is more about the requirements that are getting groomed in this session. We're not talking about any design or any technical discussion, anything of that sort. Okay, so the team is more focused towards understanding the requirements from the product owner perspective, and we are not getting into the design or architecture of the application, or you know, designing the or defining the coding standards or all of that.
But okay.
Now, the second most important responsibility of a product owner is to prioritize the backlog. A backlog may be or may consist of, let's say, 300 PBIs, product backlog items. But not all PBIs, all the 300 PBIs will be of equal importance, correct?
Right.
Some might be more important, some might be very critical, some might be less important, some might not, you know, even if we don't implement, that's okay, right? They are of least importance. So every PBI will have its own weightage. So the product owner will decide that weightage, and they will prioritize based on the business value they think it's giving to their organization. Okay. So that is the product owner grooming the backlog with the team. And as I said, there are two main things or main responsibilities of product owner. One is to groom the backlog with the team, and the second thing is to prioritize it and keep it in the product backlog. The product backlog is
groom the backlog in the sense, groom the backlog means just explaining them about the...
No, not only that. They will also be, you know, updating the stories with some more information. So let's take a scenario. I'm a product owner, okay? And I have a specific requirement that needs to be met in the system. As a product owner, I will write the story, a user story, and I will also write the acceptance criteria on that.
So okay. Everything will be now, decided by product owner only, right? I mean, acceptance
yes,
criteria
product,
and this.
Correct.
Backlogs.
But that's correct. But in the meeting, let's say a developer or a tester, they come up with a question which the product owner had never thought of. I may not have thought of. Let's say the tester says, hey, what happens if this thing fails? How should the system respond to it? right? Now, as a product owner, maybe I didn't think about that scenario, but now because somebody asked me that question, I need to think about it and update my story so that my story is complete, correct? The story should be able to handle all the possible scenarios, right? Not just a happy path. Your happy path, your alternate workflow, exception workflow, all of those should be able to handle.
Product owner is a technical person. I mean, because
no.
As he's discussing with the development team, so he should also understand what terms they are talking about. Development team.
Of course, I mean, you need to know basic things like, you know, because ultimately we are building a system, right? Right. So the product owner should know that what that feature is, what happens if, let's say, we are building a feature for login. Let's take a simple example. Okay. Now, as a product owner, it's okay for me to, I mean, not okay, but it's very a common sense to think about, okay, when I enter my ID password and if it's a correct match, I should be able to see my account, right? But I will also think about, what if the ID or password is incorrect? How should the system behave? Correct? What type of message you want to display? I want to see that. Now it's not, I'm not getting into the design where I will tell you that go into this database table and check my ID or password and update the log tables, right? All of that, I mean, I don't care as a product owner. That's the implementation details that the team will worry, that how the validation will take place. Okay.
Development team.
So that
development
is, yeah, correct.
Okay.
The next one is the sprint planning meeting. Now, the sprint planning meeting, you know the concept of sprint, correct?
Iteration, one iteration.
Yes. It can be like 1 week, 2 weeks.
Yeah. Just one query. It's like, so business will give all the details to product owner. Okay. Then product owner will create product backlog himself.
Correct.
And then he will discuss with the development team first. And after
that,
he will discuss that thing with development team.
That's correct.
Okay. And after that, this sprint planning meeting will come. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So the product backlog grooming itself is where the team will be involved. Okay, so the product backlog grooming meeting is the main meeting which will happen between the product owner and the team, and they will have that discussion so that the team also understands what's going on. Okay, and as I said, the team may give input to the product owner saying, hey, what should the system do if this happens, or what type of message do we want to display? Maybe the product owner didn't think about it. All of these things will be discussed, and the product owner will then go and update the story, right? So that it's complete and can be implemented in the way we should. Got it?
Right.
Clear?
Okay.
The sprint planning meeting is a second ceremony which will happen. Actually, it happens at the beginning of a sprint. And as the name says, you are planning the sprint. Now, sprint can be for 1 week, it can be for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, or 4 weeks. You can also custom define your sprint. It doesn't have to be 1 to 4 weeks. You can also say, I want to have 2.5 weeks, one sprint, or I want to have 3 weeks and 3 days. That's my one sprint. But why would you do that, right? So you will stick to either 1, 2, 3, or 4 weeks. Now, it's very rare to have 1 week sprint or 4 week sprint. Generally, the teams I've seen will go with 2 weeks or 3 weeks.
Okay.
Like how here we have, it's a 3 week sprint, right?
Okay.
So let's assume that it's a 2 week sprint. Okay. Or 3 week. Let's go with the same example, 3 week. So what will happen is before the start of the sprint, the team will take a look at the backlog. Okay. Now, as I said, the backlog may have like 200, 300 items. Now, the team will not select all of them, right? Because it's not feasible to do all of those in one sprint. So the team will select one by one those PBIs which have been groomed properly and which have been prioritized by the product owner, right? They will, let's say they take the, they first look at the, I mean, they look at the first story and they say, okay, you know, we are good with this. We understand what needs to be done. And that will be put into the sprint backlog. Okay. Similarly, they will take a look at the second story. They will say, okay, you know, yeah, we understand this story. It's pretty easy, or, you know, it's clear. We don't have any questions. Or if there are any questions, the PO will be there, the PA will be there, and they will be asking these questions to the product owner, BA. And based on the response they get, they will either they will say, okay, let's take it in the sprint backlog, or if the requirements are not clear, then we may need more discussion. So depending on that, but let's take as
but which PBI to be taken has to be decided by product owner only, right? Because he
that's already prioritized.
Okay.
Right.
And current sprint, how many PBIs we have to take?
Yeah.
That is
on velocity. No, that I will talk about that. Just
okay, fine. Okay.
We'll talk on that velocity. But first, let's say that, you know, they keep putting these PBIs into the sprint backlog. So if you see, we have two backlogs. One is a product backlog, one is sprint backlog. So product backlog is owned by the product owner. Sprint backlog is owned by the team. Okay. Now, these PBIs, as I said, the team will keep pulling these PBIs. They will review it. And if everything is complete, clear, then they will put it into the sprint backlog. But the team cannot keep doing this for all the 200, 300 PBIs, correct? They have to stop at one point of time. So what is that fact or deciding criteria that will let them say that, hey, this is enough. We cannot take more than this. That is the velocity. The team velocity is, I mean, this is just my definition, okay? The total number of PBIs a team can take in any given sprint. It's like an average. It's a mean number, okay? On an average, how many stories or how many PBIs can a team take in one single sprint? That is what the team velocity is. It's like a mileage of your car, right? You want to, when you buy a car, what do you, you know, you need to know your mileage, right? Your car's mileage. Let's say you say 20 miles per gallon, okay? Now, if you have to go from point A to point B, which is 100 miles, you know how many gallons you need. You need 5 gallons minimum to go from point A to point B, correct? Same way here, we are trying to see how many stories can we take in one single sprint. So if my team velocity is, let's say, 100 story points, so each story will have a story point. So the total, as you keep going, you will say, okay, you know, we have reached 100 now. Now we cannot take it beyond this point because we have reached our limit capacity. Maximum we can take is 100 story points because that is what we can do. That is the bandwidth our team has. Anything beyond 100 story points, we won't be able to finish it.
Story point means product backlog only.
No, story point is a numeric value which has been assigned to a story. Okay. Right. So a story point is a numeric value we assign to a story.
means the numbering 1 2 3 4 number only. It is just a number.
It is a number, but it is a special number. We use the Fibonacci numbers, like one, then it's 2 3 5 8 13, likewise. It is, we will define that, you know, how we do it.
Okay.
Right. But it's a numeric value which is assigned to us to a story point. I mean, to a story, which will tell us the complexity.
Okay.
Right. Some people also use like t-shirt sizing, right? Like, when you go to buy, let's say, a pant or t-shirt, what do you look for? You look for one is measurement, right, or a size.
Yeah, small, medium,
like,
extra.
Let's say t-shirt. You either go with a small, medium, large or extra small, whatever fits you.
Right.
Correct? It's the same concept that, you know, you want to size your story. Is it too easy? Is it, you know, too complex? Is it medium? Likewise. But the idea or the logic behind doing that is, in your sprint backlog, you have to define the total scope of the sprint. So you will take those many PBIs in your sprint backlog that you can complete, and that will depend on your velocity. So if the team's velocity is, let's say, 100 story points, that means you cannot take more than 100 story points worth of work.
Okay, so
right? The total of all the PBIs, the total story points of all the PBIs should be less than or equal to 100.
Okay.
Okay.
So, okay. So but for a first now, or second sprint, suppose we have only first sprint, then obviously there will be only product backlog, right? And in sprint, we will again decide.
Yeah.
So in that case, there will be a new velocity as such.
Yes, so it takes 2 to 3 sprints to determine the velocity, right? Because as you said, right, that okay, sorry. So as you said that, let's say you are starting a project, you don't know the velocity, correct? So how do you determine the velocity? So it's a little bit of trial and error. So first 2 3 sprints, you have to determine how much work you have you were able to take, you know, and then you have to figure out your team velocity, right? So it's more like in the initial 2 3 sprints, it's a trial and error, and then the team will determine, hey, this is actually your velocity.
But
so you won't know until you.
But velocity will never give us exact number, because what happened, there are chances that product backlog, which are part of product backlog, within product backlog there might be a different stories. Some story might be complicated, some story might be easy. Okay. So in each and every sprint there might be a different types of such a probabilities, right? I mean,
yeah, but that doesn't matter, right? That has no dependency on your velocity. Velocity, what you're saying is, this is a total story points we can take. Same thing, the example we took, you want to go from point A to point B, right? Doesn't matter, you go from point A to point C, D, E, F, G. As long as the total miles are same, it really doesn't matter. You're still getting the same mileage, correct? And you still need the same amount of gasoline, like 5 miles, right? Doesn't matter whether you go from here to point B or from A to C, A to D. As long as the total distance is 100 miles and the mileage is 20 miles per gallon, you still need 5 miles, I mean 5 gallons of gas to go from your origin to destination. Correct?
Right, right.
Okay, So that is the sprint backlog. So sprint backlog is always owned by the team.
So, like previous, like waterfall, we have the people, like you know, business analysts we had. Okay, then we have a product manager. Then we had an architect. So, who is going to take care of all these roles here?
They are part of the team. That's a team. Your solution architect, your developer, tester, your UI/UX person, your information security personnel, technical writer, everybody is part of the team.
Okay.
BA. Actually, BA is more with the product owner, okay, than the team. The BA is actually both sides. The product owner and the team. But if you ask me, the BA is more aligned to the product owner role than anyone else.
Because BA will have a domain knowledge, so he will be
Correct.
more
That's
productive.
correct.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, then comes okay, there's one more thing here. Then the sprint backlog, as I said, is always owned by the team, the Scrum team who is going to implement. That includes your solution architect, design, developer, tester, technical writer, a UI/UX person, information security personnel, all of those. And then what they will do is they will do a subtasking. Each story will be decomposed into small task or subtask. And they will own it. So let's say you are a developer. So you will own a specific subtask that is mapped to a story. Let's say I'm a tester. I will own a specific subtask which is mapped to a story. Okay. And then together, all the subtasks will be worked by the team. And once the team completes that, all the subtasks, we can say that this story is complete.
Okay, so not a single individual, single person is responsible for any story. Multiple
I mean,
developers.
generally it is not, yes, because one story will have front end, back end work, UI work, right, database work. So one person won't be able to do everything, correct? So there are multiple people who will be working on the same story, but they will, each one of them will have their own task to do.
Okay.
Okay. Clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay, and then once the team has put all the PBIs into the sprint backlog and they determine that, hey, this is the max we can take, from that point onwards, you can lock the sprint scope, right? The scope of the sprint is what's included in the sprint backlog. So, for example, we are doing sprint 5, and we had a product, I mean, sprint planning meeting for sprint 5. So, and we took, as a team, we took 10 PBIs into the sprint backlog. So that is the scope of that sprint. Once we start the sprint, we should not change the scope of that sprint.
Scope means
Correct?
number of product backlog, right?
Number of
Number.
stories we have taken in that sprint.
Okay, that is called scope. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Understood.
Okay, and then once the team has defined that this is the scope, they will lock the scope, and then from that point onwards, they will start sprinting. So let's say this sprint is for 3 weeks. Okay, so let's say today's Monday, right? So that's week one, that's week two, and that's week three. So six is a finish date of this sprint or end date of the sprint. 6th December. Okay, and what will happen is during these 15 days, the Scrum Master will be there, right? Actually, Scrum Master can be in any of the ceremonies, or and should be, because he or she facilitates all these ceremonies. But especially the daily Scrum meeting is very important for Scrum Master, because this person is responsible for removing any blockers or impediments facing the team. So let's say a developer says that, hey, you know, I'm unable to do this because of the environment is down, or I don't have the tool, or I don't have the permission, whatever the reason is. But there's an impediment, you know, he or she is facing. So a Scrum Master is responsible for removing that impediment so that person can continue working on it. Okay. So daily Scrum meeting is where the team will meet for like 15, 20 minutes every day, and they will say, okay, what they did yesterday, what they are planning to do today, and if they are facing any impediments or blockers. Okay, impediments and blockers are different actually. Blocker is something which is a showstopper. You cannot do this. Impediment is, you know, maybe it's not the best way to do it, or finding some challenges to do it. You are moving ahead, but there are a lot of hiccups along the way, right? So those kind of things can be addressed in these meetings, and the Scrum Master will be the person who will be responsible for removing these impediments and blockers, and everybody will report to each one of us. So there is no, like, you know, boss subordinate relationship here. Everybody will be reporting to each other. As they say, Scrum is it's more like a cross-functional team and self-disciplined team. So you don't have a kind of in a conventional way, right? You have a PM and a team who will be taking the orders from the PM. Here, the team is you know, self-organized, self-disciplined, and self-motivated. In at least in theory.
Okay. But the impediments you said in Scrum Master, so if it is mm-hmm. technical, obviously they will, I mean, team will not come to Scrum Master. They will solve within team itself with architecture, solution architect, or whoever, any senior person, no. Right?
Okay. See, Scrum Master doesn't mean that you have to have all the answers for the team. But you should be there to kind of, you know, facilitate and coordinate all the meetings or any conversation that needs to happen to solve that impediment or blocker, right? Okay. So let's say that you are, you get in the stand-up meeting, one of the developers says that they don't have a tool installed on their machine. So how can you help that developer to get it, right? You get that person all the point of contacts who will be responsible for installing. Hey, did you open the ticket? If not, then you follow up with that developer and see if he or she has opened the ticket. If the ticket is already there, you can check the status of the ticket and expedite it if possible, right? Those kind of things. So you don't need to have answer for everything.
What I want to say is, like, you know, suppose in daily Scrum meeting we have five developers, okay,
mm-hmm.
and they will have different issues, okay. So do I have to make a note of those issues while I'm attending Scrum meeting, or how we?
Yes, it is. Yeah, it is good to do that. Definitely, yeah, it is advisable to have that.
Or do we have to
follow that practice?
Okay. Or do we have to, because it is a like on call, right? Over call.
Yes. Right.
Okay.
And okay. See you. So what you need to do is because you're getting ready for this role, correct? So what you can do is you can, when you are doing these meetings, you can just, take a note of what's going on, and only the items which are, you know, like impediments or blockers, you can follow up on that. You don't need to worry about everything else. let's say somebody says, hey, you know, the environment is down, I cannot test it. Then as a scrum master, you need to say, okay, what's going on? Why the environment is down? Talk to the person who is responsible for that and see if, you know, how you can expedite it, right?
Okay.
So apart from these things, you will also be responsible for doing a lot of reporting the metrics data on a day-to-day basis, you know, managing all the conflicts within the team. It can be, you know, people conflicts, all of that.
Okay,
Okay.
people conflict. I mean, suppose anybody is not supporting the team or not, there is no one
Exactly.
appreciating.
Right.
So how we handle such situation? I mean, we care.
I mean, talk to them just like how you do it at home, right? No,
Yeah.
nothing different. You talk to them, see what's going on, why they are not happy, or why they are not able to support other team members. Get things done. So, it's nothing, you know, extraordinary you have to do there. Just use your basic common sense and, you know, people skills. Okay. And then we have the sprint review meeting. So at the end of the third week, what's going to happen is you will demonstrate the product which you built in that sprint. Okay, only in that sprint. So let's say you built five features in that sprint. You will demonstrate those five features in the sprint, and that is the actual working software you are going to display, you're going to demonstrate in the sprint. Not a prototype, not a wireframe, not a document. It's the actual application which you are going to demonstrate. Okay, that's a sprint review. And then finally, it's a sprint retrospective meeting. In the sprint retrospective meeting, the team will look back and they will see what they did in that sprint, how well they did, the good things they did so that they can continue. Things did not go that well or as per the plan, so that we can take a remedial action and should not repeat it in the future sprint. And there might be a case where you're doing things in the right way, but there's a scope for improvement. So you will look into those aspects. That's the last ceremony, which is sprint retrospective ceremony. Okay. Now going back to the sprint review, let me just finish that sprint review. Now the key thing here for the sprint review meeting is the team will get the feedback right from the product owner in that meeting. Okay. And the feedback is very important because based on the feedback, we can, you know, revise the product. We can make the changes to the product so that in the next sprint or any future sprint, you know, we can fix those issues. Okay. So that is basically the ceremonies we have, five ceremonies.
But in sprint preview, entire product, I mean, whichever backlogs we have in sprint backlogs, all stories are completed in sprint preview itself, right? That means that is
No,
the end
in
of
sprint,
my.
correct. In sprint review, we demonstrate those stories which we did in that sprint. So let's say in sprint five, we did 10 stories. So in sprint review meeting, we will demonstrate how those 10 stories are supported in the application.
So all contents of sprint backlog, right? Everything from of sprint
Correct.
backlog,
Exactly.
right?
Yes,
So
that's true. Yes.
my so, okay. So ultimately that will be end of my sprint review.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. And
Okay.
then you will start a new sprint once you are done with the retrospective.
Okay. So that is so it will go to production directly, or it is, I mean, how?
It depends. Again, as I said that day, it depends. You don't want to implement a product, or you don't want to give your, you know, end user product which has no value in it, correct? So when you are in the very early phase of building a solution, you may not want to do that, right? But let's say you already have one release for the product, and now in the subsequent release, then you can think of doing per sprint. Each sprint, you can push it into the production, but you don't want to do it unless it makes sense. Right? So I gave you that example, right, that day, that you don't want to just give them a login ID and password capability without also implementing authentication of that ID password.
Right.
You want to have a complete feature so that they can use it. So just by giving them login ID and login ID, logging in using ID password, if they don't see anything else, what is the point in giving them that authentication feature?
Right.
So that depends on what value it's giving to the end user. Does it make sense or not? If it doesn't make sense, then you know, I would not, I mean, nobody would release it in the production environment.
So entire sprint is been run by Scrum Master only. In that time, product owner is nowhere, not involving. I mean,
what is that?
He will only directly come to. So entire sprint is been run by Scrum Master only. And
the entire team, I would
product
say.
Owner will come.
See, Scrum Master is not somebody who is going to be like a manager sort of guy, right? A Scrum Master will be more like a supporting role who is there for the team. So the entire team is working on that. It's not only Scrum Master, but I think what you're trying to say is, one second. What you're trying to say is that a Scrum Master will be the person who is overseeing the team.
Like TL sort of, you know, product owner like a manager and Scrum Master, you can consider as a TL, like that's how it is. I mean,
can you repeat that?
Like product owner will be so like a manager and Scrum Master will be like team lead. That's how it is. So he is going to manage the team or something.
Yeah, you can think about that. Scrum Master as a PM without any authoritative role or authoritative what do you call trait.
Then why team will come to Scrum Master only? They can go to product owner directly.
See, product owner is not a technical person, right? Most of the times, the product owner will not tell or will not solve if there's a server is down or if the system is not performing at the speed at which it should. Like if the performance is slow for some reason, you cannot contact product owner and ask for help, right? The PO will say that, you know, it's not my lookout. You guys have to fix it,
okay,
right?
So they will
the product owner is coming from the requirement side. Think about product owner as an SME. A subject matter expert, whereas a Scrum Master is coming from the project manager side. So if anything is not working or anything problem, any sort of problem, the team will look at a PM, right? Same thing here. Right, so that's a Scrum framework which we will be expanding on that. Okay, what we'll do is we will take each ceremony and expand on that going forward.
Okay. Sorry, today I asked so many questions actually, you know. So many
no
small, small things are there actually.
Yeah, do one thing, prepare your list of questions and now we will meet on the weekend, okay? We will meet on Saturday, but before that, if you want to come up with the list of questions, we can do that. I mean, prepare your questions, and on Saturday we can go through those.
Sure. Saturday we will start working on each.
Yeah, same time, 9.
Product owner.
What's that? Yeah.
From Saturday onwards, correct. We will start more working on product owner its exact role and everything. Scrum Master,
That's
its
right.
exact role. Okay.
That's
Okay, fine.
correct.
Okay, that
Right?
will, I think, give me more idea, more clear picture.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay, and
Sure.
the recording, can you share the recording immediately to me? And one more
Yes,
recording
I
is
will do
also
that.
pending, that
You
rough
didn't
one.
get that?
Okay.
I sent you. You
You
didn't get
sent me
that?
only one recording, which was, I think,
No,
you
no,
sent
no.
only
The
one recording.
one we did on this Saturday, I sent that. But for
Yeah.
some reason, you know, that on your the new account, the Scrum Master account, it's not opening. That's what the problem is. I don't know why. So what I did was I shared it on your this thing, the Gmail and Yahoo as well.
But
Did you
it's
get
not
that?
opening. Yeah, I checked, it's not opening.
It's not opening there.
No, same one. Yes, same situation. The same problem
Okay.
which we faced earlier in videos.
It's the same thing, right? Because it's
Yes.
opening on my local. It's opening on my local, but it's not opening in the drive. I don't know why, what the reason is. But let me do one thing. If not, then I will just use Vimeo then. Okay, so that at
Sure.
least we don't have to break our head on this issue.
Yes,
Right?
okay. Okay.
Okay then.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, see you. Yeah, I'll
Okay, yeah,
talk to you on
thank you.
Saturday then, okay? Bye.
Sure,
Thank
yeah.
you.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Did you receive that payment? Because
Yeah,
for the
I got it.
confirmation.
Thank you. Yes, I got it.
Yeah,
Thanks.
I mean, I just need a confirmation because,
Yeah, I got
it's
it.
good. Okay, man. Okay. Thank
Okay.
you very much.
Yeah, bye.
Okay, bye.
Thank you. Thanks for the payment. Bye.
Yeah, okay.